Hi guys, welcome to Real Time Automation. In our last video, we have seen framework how to develop a Maven project. So let me open what all things we covered in our last video. So these are the things like how to set up Maven project from scratch. What are the prerequisites for that one, and group ID, artifact ID, and the dependencies that we need. So now today in this video we are going to see how to segregate the step definitions, pages or classes. So whatever the things that we are going to see today in this video regarding the segregation of the things. So mainly I will show you like we'll create one package for runner classes and step definition. So runner class is the main you can say like through which we can trigger our scripts. This is the main like step definition. All the glue codes we will keep under this class. So before that one, let me show you like in a POM file how to segregate the packages. There should be like naming convention that you need to follow. Go to pom.xml. Here you can see like group ID and followed by, always you need to make sure that you are following this structure, group ID and artifact ID. So right click here, new package, .selenium, okay. Thing is like you need to follow, you need to keep it as all. Dot step definitions. No, we'll give it as runner. This is not runner, we'll do it. Okay. So you can see here another package we'll create for step definition. Real time automation dot selenium dot, okay, dot step definition. So we have to, one is for step definition classes, all we are segregating those classes with under this package, and all the runner classes we are segregating under this package. So class, and always class name should start with a capital letter. So now the runner class has been created. I have written the runner class already pre-heap only. I will going to explain the things to you what exactly they are. Before to that, I will create one step definition class also. So this is the main runner classes that we are triggering our feature files, right? This is the main class that through which in TestNG how you are triggering your scripts with XML file. In the similar way, through JUnit we are running the scripts of this feature file using these runner classes. So you can see the glue code, what exactly meaning of this glue code, right? Once we write the feature files and generate the step glue codes, we'll place it under this step definition. So we need to give path of this package. So whatever the path is there, right, you can write it for is real time. This is the package, the path of this package where the glue codes are present under this classes only, right? Glue codes are present. So we are writing the path of this one, real time automation dot selenium dot step. So, and another thing is like we need to give the pass the where our exactly feature files are present, features. So currently I have not written any feature, but this under this folder structure only I will maintaining all the feature files. So I am giving the path of this one. So let's go to properties. And okay, let me bring it down. So this is tags. Once we write the feature file, right, different feature file, what are the feature file, we'll be segregating them with the tags. So in TestNG, how we are forming the groups, right? Group ID, so in XML file, whatever the group we are passing that it is going to run. In the similar way, through these tags, we can run the, if there are 10 feature files, we can differentiate them with the tags, and whatever the tags we are passing here, it is going to pick up that particular feature file. I am going to explain these things, how to write a feature file and how to integrate that one with the step definition in my next video. So if you have any doubts or queries, you can comment it out, or you can connect with me by a real-time automation. There is a page on Facebook, you can connect with me there, so I can answer your questions. Thanks guys, thanks for watching my video.